Hello and welcome to the fourth module. Till the third module, we were seeing some of the methods of solving quadratic equations. From the fourth module, we'll be going for some application. Fourth and fifth module, we'll go for some applications based on the quadratic equations. Yesterday, we have seen how to solve a quadratic equation with the help of the formula method, right? Now here, the formula was something like this one. X is equal to, or x or y is equal to, minus b plus or minus under root b squared minus 4ac upon 2a. Right? Now this particular component of the formula decides the nature of the roots, and hence this part of this formula is called as discriminant. That is, b square minus 4ac decides the nature of the roots. Now what do you actually mean by nature of the roots? Nature means whether the roots are real, unreal. Unreal means the roots really does not exist, or sometimes the roots may be equal, the roots may be distinct, right? So all this information is given by this b square minus 4ac, and we denote this particular expression b square minus 4ac as delta. Yesterday we have, in the last module we have seen it. So delta is equal to b square minus 4ac. Now if an equation is given, say for example, they give us an equation 2x squared minus 3x plus 5 equal to 0. And suppose if we are asked to find the nature of the roots, there's no need to find the roots actually. By just finding the value of b squared minus 4ac, we can predict the nature of the roots of this quadratic equation. So sometimes in the exam, for one mark question, they'll be giving an equation and they'll ask us to find the nature of the roots. Right? In that case, we have to just find the nature of the roots rather than finding the roots itself. Right? Now here, so what are the basic criteria? If you just concentrate on the formula, that is x is equal to minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac upon 2a. Just imagine, suppose, if b square minus 4ac is 0, that means this quantity is 0. This is 0. So the roots will be minus b plus 0 upon 2a and minus b minus 0 upon 2a. That is same as saying as minus b upon 2a and minus b upon 2a. Where a and b are real numbers. Therefore, we will be getting two identical and real roots. So, I mean to say that if b square minus 4ac is equal to 0, then we will be getting real and equal roots. If this quantity is greater than 0, say which quantity? B square minus 4ac is greater than 0. So here we will be getting some terms here, b square minus 4ac. So if it is greater than 0, matlab it is positive number, say example 5. Example ki baat kar raha hai. So the roots will be minus b plus root 5 upon 2a and minus b minus root 5 upon 2a. In that case, both of them are real roots, but they are distinct. Real and distinct. Distinct means alag alag, right? And if b square minus 4ac is less than 0, say for example minus 5. तो रेडिकल साइन के अंदर नेगेटिव साइन नहीं आ सकता है. अकॉर्डिंग टू द डेफिनेशन ऑफ रियल नंबर्स, द स्क्वायर ऑफ एनी रियल नंबर इज ऑलवेज पॉजिटिव. सपोज इफ आई फाइंड द स्क्वायर ऑफ अ नेगेटिव नंबर, है ना, द स्क्वायर एंड स्क्वायर रूट कैंसिल, इट कम्स आउट टू बी माइनस 5, व्हिच इज नॉट पॉसिबल. दैट मींस दीज आर नॉट रियल रूट्स. सो हमको एक इंफॉर्मेशन ऐसा मिलता है कि अगर b square minus 4ac is equal to 0, then the roots are real and equal. Real and equal. If b square minus 4ac is greater than 0, means value of b square minus 4ac is positive, then the roots are real and distinct. Distinct means different roots, right? It can be 5, 3, 8, minus 7, whatever it may be. They will be real and distinct. And if b square minus 4ac is less than 0, then no real roots exist. No real roots exist. Now here, as a matter of convenience, whenever we are asked to find the roots of any quadratic equation, what I suggest is that first find the value of the discriminant. If the discriminant is less than 0, then no need to find the roots because no real roots exist. And if it is either equal to 0 or greater than 0, then only we should find the roots of the given equation. Right? Now, just to find some, we'll take some examples to find the nature of the roots. Say here it is given that 2x square minus 3x plus 5 equal to 0. Comparing this equation with the general form of the equation, that is ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, we come to the conclusion that a is 2, b is minus 3 and c is 5. And just find the value of this discriminant, that is b square minus 4ac. Ka value find karenge hum b square, matlab minus 3 ka square is 9, minus 4 times 2 and c is 5. That is equal to 9 minus 4, 2 is 8, 5 is 40. So 9 minus 40 is minus 31. And since b square minus 4ac, b square minus 4ac ka value is minus 31, which is less than 0. So we can directly say that no real roots exist. Samajh mein aa raha hai aapko? Just find the value of b square minus 4ac. If it is less than 0, here in this case it is less than 0, no real roots exist. If it is equal to 0, real and equal. If it is greater than 0, then it will be real and distinct. Alright. Now I'll take one more example. See, they say that find the nature of the roots given that, given the equation 3x squared minus 4 root 3 plus 4 is equal to 0. Now comparing this equation with the general form of the equation, we know that a will be equal to 3, b is equal to minus 4 root 3 and c is equal to 4. Just find the value of the discriminant, that is delta is equal to b square minus 4ac. B square matlab iska square minus 4 root 3 ka square minus 4 times a is 3, c is 4. That is, since it is a square of a negative number, it will be positive. 4 ka square is 16 and root 3 ka square is 3. 16, 3 is a 48 minus 4, 4 is a 16, 3 is a 48. That is equal to 0. Since delta is equal to 0, the roots are real and equal. Jab delta ka value is equal to 0, the roots will be real and equal. If it is less than 0, no real roots exist. If it is greater than 0, then roots will be real and distinct. Aapko yaad rakhna hai. Right? We will take some more formulas, sorry, some more numericals. See, if it is given that 2x squared minus 6x plus 3 is equal to 0. So once again, comparing the equation with this one, we'll get a is equal to 2, b is equal to minus 6 and c is equal to 3. So if we'll find the value of the discriminant, delta is equal to b square minus 4 times a into c. That is 36 minus 4 to the 8 and 8 3s are 24. 36 minus 24, 6 minus 4 is 2, 12. So delta is 12. So we can say that delta is greater than 0, means the roots are real and distinct. समझ में आया? Now sometimes, based on this nature of the roots, some word problems are given. They are very easy problems actually. Say for example, they can ask us, if the roots of the quadratic equation x square plus px plus 25 is equal to 0 are equal, then find the value of p. What is given? एक क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन दिया हुआ है जिसमें b का वैल्यू नहीं दिया हुआ है. इट इज समथिंग वी हैव टू फाइंड p. यहां पे इट इज इन टर्म्स ऑफ p. सो x स्क्वायर प्लस px प्लस 25 इक्वल टू 0 एंड अ कंडीशन इज गिवन दैट द रूट्स ऑफ दिस क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशंस आर इक्वल. सो व्हेन एंड वी हैव टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ p. सो व्हेन रूट्स आर इक्वल, हाउ टू फाइंड, मींस व्हाट इज द कंडीशन? कंडीशन इज द डेल्टा शुड बी इक्वल टू 0. कि कहां से आया डेल्टा इज इक्वल टू 0? बिकॉज हमको कंडीशन दिया हुआ है कि इसकी जो रूट्स हैं दे आर रियल. इसके पहले हम क्या फाइंड करते थे कि इफ द रूट्स आर रियल, इफ डेल्टा इज इक्वल टू 0 द रूट्स आर रियल एंड इक्वल. गेटिंग? कॉन्वर्सली, इफ इट इज गिवन दैट द रूट्स आर इक्वल, द रूट्स आर इक्वल, इट मीन्स दैट डेल्टा शुड बी इक्वल टू 0. बट हु इज डेल्टा? कंपेयरिंग दिस इक्वेशन विद द जनरल फॉर्म ऑफ द इक्वेशन, ए इज इक्वल टू 1, b is equal to p, c is equal to 25. So delta is b square minus 4ac is equal to 0. B square means p square. Minus 4 times 1 into 25 is equal to 0. So p square minus 100 is equal to 0. Or p is equal to, p square is equal to 100. Or p is equal to plus or minus 10. If p का वैल्यू प्लस 10 और माइनस 10 रहा, then the roots will be equal. So यहाँ पे कंडीशन क्या दिया हुआ उन्होंने? कंडीशन ये दिया हुआ है कि डेल्टा अगर 0 है तो p का वैल्यू क्या क्या हो सकता है? तो p का वैल्यू या तो प्लस 10 हो सकता है या माइनस 10 हो सकता है. राइट? सो दिस टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन कम्स फॉर 2 marks. मतलब आपको एक इक्वेशन दिया हुआ रहेगा जिसमें एक अननोन टर्म दिया रहेगा और कंडीशन दिया रहेगा कि फाइंड the value of that particular unknown term. Okay, एक क्वेश्चन ले लेंगे जिसमें तीनों कंडीशंस आ गए हुए हैं. एक हमको इक्वेशन दिया हुआ उन्होंने कि पी एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस 4√3x प्लस 3 इज इक्वल टू 0. फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ p, सो दैट हमको p का वैल्यू फाइंड करना है, p का वैल्यू फाइंड करना है so that the roots are real, the roots are not real and the roots are equal. तीन condition दिया हुआ है, right? पहला condition दिया हुआ है if the roots are real, right? Second is non-real and third one equal, right? Now real के लिए, for real roots, condition क्या है? Delta should be greater than or equal to 0. Now remember here, don't get confused here. When delta was equal to 0, we had real and equal roots. When delta is greater than 0, we had real and distinct roots. Yahan pe condition kya bola hua hai? Find the value of p if the roots of this equation are real roots. So रियल और इक्वल भी हो सकते हैं और रियल और डिस्टिंक भी हो सकते हैं. इसलिए आई हैव टेकन डबल कंडीशन हियर, डेल्टा इज आइदर ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू 0. नाउ वी विल फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ डेल्टा. नाउ डेल्टा का वैल्यू हम अलग से फाइंड कर लेते हैं. डेल्टा इज इक्वल टू बी स्क्वायर माइनस 4ac, दैट इज इक्वल टू 4√3 का स्क्वायर माइनस 4 टाइम्स a इज p एंड दिस इज 3. एग्रीड? That is equal to 48. 4 ka square is 16. √3 ka square is 3. So 16 threes are 48 minus 12p. This is the value of delta, that is discriminant. Now for the first condition, for real roots, delta should be greater than or equal to 0, means 48 minus 12p should be greater than or equal to 0. Right. Now if I transpose this to this side, so I'll be getting 12p. And अरे इसको हमने इधर ले लिया हुआ है, getting यहाँ पे, right? So less than 48. So p less than or equal to 48 upon 12. 12 ones and 12 fours are. That means p should be less than or equal to 4. In this case, if p is less than or equal to 4, then only we'll have real roots. Agreed? Samajh mein aaya? Now if I take p is equal to 4, 12 fours are 48. Delta will be equal to 0. And if it is greater than 4, p is less than 4. Less than 4 agar humne liya, then we will be getting real roots. Real and distinct roots. Samajh mein aaya? Now, इसी क्वेश्चन में उन्होंने दिया हुआ था पहला कंडीशन, इट वॉज फॉर रियल रूट्स. सेकेंड कंडीशन इज फॉर अनरियल रूट्स, और इफ फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ पी सच दैट दिस इक्वेशन डज नॉट हैव और डू नॉट हैव एनी रियल रूट्स. सो अनरियल, या फिर उसको हम कॉम्प्लेक्स रूट्स भी बोलते हैं, है ना. अनरियल, अनरियल रूट्स के लिए कंडीशन इज delta should be less than 0. Perfectly less than 0. Delta is b square minus 4ac less than 0. And this is delta value. So 48 minus 12p less than 0. I can transpose this to the side. So this will be 12p in a way. 12p, right. And here it will be 48. So 12 ko mere transpose kar dete hain. So if p is greater than 4, no real roots exist. Koi bhi real roots exist nahi karega. Right? And the last condition, equal roots. Equal roots ke liye condition is delta should be equal to 0. That means 48 minus 12p is equal to 0. So 12p is equal to 48. और p is equal to 4. So यहाँ पे एक ही क्वेश्चन में मैंने तीनों कंडीशंस ले लिया हुआ है, जस्ट टू मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड द सिचुएशन, लाइक, है ना, कि अगर कोई इक्वेशन दिया हुआ है, सम अननोन थिंग इज गिवन एंड सम कंडीशन इज गिवन, सो वी हैव टेकन ऑल थ्री कंडीशन एट द सेम टाइम, राइट. सो वी फाउंड दैट फॉर रियल एंड इक्वल रूट्स p शुड बी इक्वल टू 4. गेट इट? Now, in the third module, purposely I have taken only two numericals because इसके आगे जो हमको word problems करना है, उस उन word problems को हम generally for practice purpose, I'll be going to solve it using the third method, that is formula method, right? So, now there are certain basic things which should be understood for framing a word problem, right? Now, actually, what is a word problem? Word problem means आपको एक situation दिया हुआ रहेगा. Using those situations and conditions, we have to frame a equation and then solve that quadratic equation and then get the value of the variable. Say, for example, if I say that the product of two consecutive natural numbers is 56. The product of two consecutive natural numbers is 56. What are the numbers? तो हम क्या assume करते हैं? Let the two numbers, consecutive natural numbers. Natural मतलब positive numbers रहेगा, right? Now consecutive मतलब एक के बाद एक आने वाला है. Suppose if there is a number say 17. How to get the next number? It is plus 1. 17 plus 1. अगर एक नंबर है हमारे पास 15, तो 15 के बाद में कौन सा नंबर आता है? 15 प्लस 1, दैट इज 16, राइट. तो वैसे ही लेट द फर्स्ट नंबर बी x, लेट द फर्स्ट नंबर बी x. तो x का कॉन्जिगेटिव नेचुरल नंबर इट विल बी आइदर एक्स के बाद में हो सकता है या एक्स के पहले भी हो सकता है. सो सिंस वी अवॉइड नेगेटिव टर्म्स और नेगेटिव साइंस, आई गो फॉर द टर्म आफ्टर एक्स. सो द नेक्स्ट कॉन्सिक्यूटिव टर्म आफ्टर एक्स विल बी एक्स प्लस वन, राइट. ये आपको स्टेटमेंट्स लिखना पड़ेगा. लेट द टू कॉन्सिक्यूटिव नेचुरल नंबर्स, और लेट द फर्स्ट नेचुरल नंबर बी एक्स, देयरफॉर द कॉन्सिक्यूटिव नेचुरल नंबर, नेक्स्ट कॉन्सिक्यूटिव नेचुरल नंबर विल बी एक्स प्लस वन. And what is the condition? According to the given condition. Now, what is the given condition? Condition is the product of these two. That is, x into x plus 1 is 56. Now, let's simplify this one. So, x into x will be x squared plus x is equal to 56. This is not in the standard form. So, we'll bring it into the standard form. So, we'll have x square plus x minus 56 is equal to 0. Now this is a quadratic equation, and we can solve this quadratic equation using any of the methods. Now it is not necessary that you should use the first method or the second method, something of that sort, right? So I'll try to solve it using the formula method, because in the formula method ke module mein, we have done only two numericals, right? Now this is the given, or this is the equation we got it. Now here, comparing this equation with ax square plus bx plus c, we'll get a is equal to 1, b is equal to 1, and c is equal to minus 56, right? Iske baad wala yahan pe, and the formula kya bolta hai? Formula is, before that, we'll find delta. Delta is b square minus 4ac. That is equal to b square. It is 1 ka square. Minus 4 times a into c is 56. That is equal to 1. So this is minus 56. Minus into minus will be plus. 4 6 are 24. 4 5 are 20 plus 2 22. So this is 225. So delta ka value is 225. Right? So we are solving this equation by formula method, because humne module 3 mein the quadratic equation को मुझे solve किया था, only we have taken only two problems, है ना, थोड़ा सा practice भी हो जाएगा इसमें. So delta का value हो गया 225. Now formula is x is equal to minus b plus or minus under root b square minus 4ac upon 2a. That is equal to minus b means minus 1 plus or minus root of 225 upon 2 into 1, that is 2. That is equal to minus 1 plus 15 upon 2, and minus 1 minus 15 upon 2. So here it will be 14 upon 2, that is 7, and here it will be minus 16 upon 2, that is minus 8. Now numerically, algebraically, this equation is satisfied. I rubbed it out actually. This equation is satisfied by either x is equal to 7 or minus 8. But our assumption kya tha? Let x be the natural number. Therefore, x is equal to minus 8 is discarded. Our jo two numbers the x and x plus 1. To usme hum kaun sa lenge? 7. So x is 7, 7 plus 1 is 8. So the two numbers, two consecutive natural numbers whose product is 56 are 7 and 8. And you can check your answers. 7 8s are 56. Samajh mein aaya? So word problems mein you have to frame the word problem ko use karke, uske condition use karke. You have to frame an equation and then solve the equation using that particular thing. Right? So we'll stop it here, just because आज हमने नेचर ऑफ रूट्स भी फाइंड किया था, एंड नेचर ऑफ रूट्स बेस्ड ऑन नेचर ऑफ रूट्स हमने दो दिन न्यूमेरिकल्स किए थे, देन वर्ड प्रॉब्लम्स का इंट्रोडक्शन शुरू कर दिया हुआ है. नाउ व्हाट आई सजेस्ट पीपल इज दैट आपके जो टेक्स्ट बुक में जो वर्ड प्रॉब्लम्स आर देयर, यू ट्राई टू सॉल्व देम यूजिंग योर इंग्लिश नॉलेज. एक्चुअल में वर्ड प्रॉब्लम इज नॉट, ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा ये मैथ से कंसर्न नहीं है, ये आपके इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज से कंसर्न है. If your language is good, you understand the numericals or the word problems better and you can solve them, right? Anyway, so you should solve it from your textbook word problems, and aapko jo bhi difficulties aata hai, kal main kya karunga aapko, in the sense next module mein I'll be taking some word problems, typical word problems, like what problems based on work time, then what problem based on distance time, what problem based on currency notes, depend अलग अलग टाइप के ये रहता है, फ्रैक्शंस बेस्ड ऑन फ्रैक्शंस, ये अलग अलग रहते हैं. तो आई विल जस्ट फाइंड आउट सम टिपिकल क्वेश्चंस बेस्ड ऑन दिस वन व्हिच हैव कम इन द बोर्ड एग्जाम्स. मोस्टली वो क्वेश्चन हम ट्राई टू सॉल्व इट ऑन द बोर्ड, एंड आफ्टर कंप्लीट दिस वर्ड प्रॉब्लम्स, रिमेंबर वन थिंग दैट वर्ड प्रॉब्लम को सॉल्व करने के लिए एक पर्टिकुलर मेथड इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट. राइट, वर्ड प्रॉब्लम में फ्रेमिंग ऑफ द इक्वेशन इज इम्पॉर्टेंट, एंड वंस द इक्वेशन इज फ्रेम्ड then you can use any of the methods. कौन कौन से methods हमारे पास? It is by completing the square method, factorization method, and by using formula method. So any of the method you can use it.